Hi, my name is Roxana, and I will show you how to install Zend Framework 2 today. The point is, when I tried to install it for the first time, it really gave me some big headaches because I could not find the proper documentation, but most important, I did not find it explained for a beginner. So I will try to make it as simple and quickly as I can. First of all, we go to framework.zend.com. If you don't want to type this address in the URL, you can Google it. And from here, we go to the Learn tab. Here, scroll down a little, and you'll see the Getting Started for Zend Framework 2 and Zend Framework 1. We want to install Zend Framework 2, so we click it. Here is best if you read all the documentation, but I will do it for you in some quick steps. The most important things that first, you must be sure that you have a PHP 5.3 or above. To do this, you can do it two ways to verify what version of PHP you have. I can go to my WAMP server and look at the PHP and version, mine is 5.3, or we can go to localhost, and here we have PHP info, we click it, and on top of the PHP info we see the PHP version, as I said, 5.3. The next thing we have to check is that we have the PDO extension. To check it, the same, we go to PHP info, we do a control F and search for the PDO. So I have the API extension PDO MySQL. So this is done. Next thing, let's see what we have to check, that your a page installation must have the most mod rewrite extension installed and configured. To check this, we go to WAMP, Apache, HTTP dconfig, open it, and let's do a search. They said mod rewrite, and you can see it. Sorry. My mod rewrite doesn't have the pound, the comment in front of it. This is how yours must look. Okay, so this is done. For the moment, we can close this file and go to the next step. This is downloading the Zend framework. We click next, and here we see this link, github.com/zend-skeleton-application. We control click on it to open it in another tab. And from here, we download the zip file. I have already downloaded it on my desktop, so you do it. So let's see my download. Here it is, extract it. Okay, after that make sure see check, because it's a folder inside another folder, and rename it how do you like. I will call it my Zend. After this, I go to my WAMP directory file, mine is on C, WAMP www, and I cut it from here and move it here. So I close this, I delete this because I don't need it anymore, and now I have my Zend skeleton application in my Zend file. Let's see what we have to do next. Now let's put it here. So we have unzipped it, we have renamed it, not like this, but you can name it like you like, how do you want, it doesn't matter. The next thing, you have to make sure you have the composer installed on your machine, because as it says here, it resolves its dependencies. In this case, the dependency is Zend Framework itself. To check that we have the composer installed, we go to our start menu and search the Windows PowerShell. After it's opened, we have to go in our to our directory. So we say change directory, C, wamp / www my zend and enter. Oh, sorry, my zend, not my zend. So I'm here to check if I have the composer installed. I write composer and enter and see how beautiful it looks. So if you don't have the composer installed, we have here a link, http getcomposer.org. You can go here and download the composer, install it, and after that pick up where we left. So after we saw that we have the composer, the next thing is to put these two lines inside. The first will self-update the composer, and the second one will install it if you don't have it. So we put these two lines, we can copy it, I don't like to type. So now enter, we wait a little. So mine is done. You have to see this generating auto loaded files to see that everything went okay. Now everything is finished with our Zend Framework installation. Now the only thing left is to configure our virtual host. First, we have to make sure that the name virtual host is set to 18. We do that by going to C, WAMP, bin, Apache, I don't know how to pronounce it correctly, so sorry. Config and extra and open our http://vhost.config. Here we see name virtual host is at asterisk, I think it's called 80. So this is okay. Let's see now what we have to do. Ah, we have to define a new host. You copy this thing here. I will have a transcript for you at the end of this tutorial, so you have everything written point by point. But if you want to type it, pause the movie and type this. So we take it, copy it, and we put it, let's say, in front of all this. Here is the name. We change this to how you called your file. I called it my Zend. This the path to my Zend is C/my Zend. So my path is this. What did I do? It's this. C. Wamp. www.myzend-public. If you have another path, please put it. And we change the directory as well. So the rest remain. It's everything okay. So this is finished. We save. And close it. Next thing, we have to go to local disk, Windows, system -32, drivers, etc, and host, and open it with notepad like this, and add the new path to our new server. You can copy this from here and let's put it here, and instead of ZF2 we make my Zend. Okay, indent it nicely, save this as well, close it, and after you did all this, please don't forget to restart all your services or the Apache service. You go here, services, restart. You see this turning red. Okay, now let's go to localhost here. Under your projects, I have my folder with my Zend installation. If I go to public, here it is. We have installed Zend Framework 2. Congratulations! From now on, go and learn, I say. So, please keep following this channel. Goodbye and see you next time.